Allow me to introduce myself. My name is China Horton Olighton. Welcome, my kings and queens, to the One in a Million show, where you are encouraged to stand out and become the best version of yourself through Christ. Please tune in every Saturday at 2:15 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on WCVG 1320 a.m. And remember, with God, all things are possible. Hello, welcome my kings and queens to the One in a Million show. I am so excited to be here on this lovely Saturday, and today I am going to bring you a word. If you are viewing via Facebook, then you can always see what the topic is. And title of today's message is, my problems are big, but God is bigger. Once again, my problems are big, but God is bigger. So let's go ahead and get into this word. Now, I'm pretty sure a lot of you already know what the word problem mean, but if you don't, and if you don't have no problems in your life, then hallelujah, praise the Lord for you. But let me go ahead and break down what problem is according to Google Dictionary. So it just means here. So it's a matter or situation regarded as unwelcome or harmful, needing to be dealt with or overcome. It also can mean difficulty, issue, trouble, worry, complication, or just keeping it simple and in the layman's terms, a difficult situation. So that is what a problem is. So we can just be real quick before we get into the word. The year 2020 has been one of the most, I would say it'll be one of the most memorable years that we will always have in mind. This has definitely been a year that we can reflect on. And if you haven't went through anything this year, I don't know where you've been at, but you should have went through something this year. You know, we have so many people, even in, you know, family members that has died from COVID-19. We have people that was diagnosed with it. And, you know, one of my personal friends was diagnosed with it and, you know, and healed by the grace of God. So it's just been so much that's been going on in the year of 2020, but not even just with COVID. You know, people have problems outside of that. People have, you know, problems with their families. People have problems with, you know, their jobs. People have problems with at work. People have problems with school. All different types. It's so many problems that I can't even just, you know, talk about right now. We all have our very own personal problems, things, trials and tribulations that we go through. And it's hard. It's hard. And sometimes you can feel like you are sinking in these problems. Sometimes you feel like, God, where are you at? You see what I'm going through? Like, where are you at? And it's so hard to balance everything that's going on. And you can feel hopeless. You feel like, God, where are you? Do you see what I'm going through right now? But we're going to look into some scriptures that's going to help encourage us, you know, in this draft season of where we feel like it's just problem after problem, or things, you just feel like things are getting better. But in the backhand, God is already working on it on our behalf. That's what we don't see. But we'll get into that later. And then I'll also share a little, you know, personal testimony of my own that I endured this week. And then I'll go into some more scripture. So the first scripture I want to go to is James 1, verse 2 through 4. And it says, count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds. For you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness. And let steadfastness have its full effect, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking in nothing. So what does that mean? It said, count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials of various kinds. Why would the writer say, count it all joy when I'm coming into trials and tribulation? Well, what the writer is indicating is, okay, we know that we're going to go through stuff, right? I just named like a ton of things that we might be even facing right now. Financial problems, children problems. It could be anything. Just a lot of things that we're just going through. Stress, mental health issues, all type of things that we just may not even talk about to others. But what the writer is indicating is, even though that we experience these type of things in life, even though we go through the hardest tests and the hardest tribulations, it's saying count it all joy, because after all of that, God is going to come through like he always come through and be steadfast. What does steadfast mean? Steadfast means to live a life of faithful endurance amid troubles and afflictions. So that means even though I'm going through something crazy right now, and God, it just seemed like I can't see the light at the end of this tunnel, I'm still going to give you your praise. I'm still going to count it all joy because I know that you're going to have my back. And I know that even though that I'm going through this very thing right now, it's making me better. Think of a problem that you probably going through right now. Something that's really real, something you probably haven't even talked to people about, something that you went through in your past, something that you just know, like, man, I need God right now. Think about all of the stuff you've been through in your past. Every time God brings us out of those situations. So if we're experiencing something right now, why would God just leave us right here just to go through something? Every time I've went through something in my life, I grew from it. I learned something, and it made me closer to God. Why? Because it made me depend on him. It made me, because I can't rely on my own strength, right? So my emotions are always changing. I get sad. I get mad. I get angry. I get happy. But with God, my strength is in him. So if I depend on him and I trust and lean onto God, I know that there's going to be a way out. I've been through so many things and God has got me out. So this very thing that I'm in now, why would he leave me here? Why would he bring me this far just for me to be left in this pit hole? You understand? So whatever it is, this is what the writer is saying. I'm going to read the scripture one more time. It says, count it all joy, my brothers, when you meet trials and various kinds. When they say various kinds, it means exactly what it means. Various kinds. There's going to be all type of issues that come into our life. All type of issues that come into our lives. But God is going to be with us every step of the way. And then it says, for you know that the testing of your faith produces steadfastness. We have to endure. We have to go through that. You strap up, you put on your plate of righteousness. You put on your faith helmet. You put on everything. You gear up in the Lord and you get through it. You have to go through hard times. That's a part of life. But you're going to get through it. So moving on, I want to talk about, some things that I even went through this week. And I'll be honest, I like to be very transparent when I'm on my show. And I just like to be as honest as possible. A lot of you know that my husband is in Nigeria currently. And it's a struggle. It's a struggle for me. I know this week it was really heavy on my heart this week. I miss him. You know, I wish that I can be with my husband right now. When COVID broke out, I planned to go to Nigeria and spend some time there, you know, about a month or so there to spend some time there. And COVID got in the middle of that. So I couldn't go. And, you know, just think about, you know, being married to someone and not being able to see them on a daily basis. That can get heavy. That can be hard to deal with. And I know somebody had asked me, you know, at work, like, how do you wake up every morning with a smile? You come in happy, you come in jolly. And, you know, here it is. You have this husband that's in Nigeria. Like, how do you do that? But that's nothing but the grace of God. It's God that strengthens me. And then, you know, God brought us together. And I know he's going to continue to bring us together. I know that our journey is not over. It's hard right now. I have my moments where I'm just like, oh, God, like, when are you going to do it? When are you going to do it? But I know he's going to do it. I know that God is going to come through. But this is a season for me personally where God is strengthening me with my patience. He's strengthening me with, you know, trusting in his word. Because if I'm going on the radio, I'm going in church, or I'm going on my workplace, and I'm encouraging people with the word of God, and I'm telling them to be encouraged, I have to believe that same word. This right here, this Bible, this is my livelihood. This is what I live by. So if I believe that, God can heal. I believe that God deliver. I believe that all of these things that he did for these other people in this Bible, he can do the same for me. For goodness sake, the way he even brought me and my husband together was super crazy and unique. That's time for another a show, but the way that he even brought me and my husband together was very unique. But I just have to think, like, dang, God. I thought about, he reminded me when I was having this, you know, weak moment, and I was just like in my feelings and just really sad about, you know, not being able to be with my husband at this moment and not being able to see him in the flesh. God reminded me of some things that I went through in my past, just, you know, some things that only that he could get me out of. He reminded me, like, China, if I did this for you back then, if I got you out of this back then, if I took you there at this place, if I did this, and I did all these things just start coming to my mind, all of these things that God had done for me in the past and all of the promises that he made that came to pass. He was like, why wouldn't I do this very thing for you, China? Why wouldn't I do it for you? And I had to sit back and really like think about it like, yeah, you know, because us, when we go through things, it's so easy for us to get sad and mad about it. We pout about it. We go to social media about it. We, you know what I'm saying? We get in our feelings about the things that we go through, but we forget that even though that we have these big problems, God is bigger. God is always bigger than our problems. He's always bigger. And I think that we lose a little faith, an inch of faith every time that we experience some big type of blowout in our life or some type of big event, something that occurred, we lose a little faith, like, oh, how I'm gonna do it, instead of saying, well, God, how are you gonna do it? We gotta stop saying, how am I'm gonna do it? Well, God, how are you gonna do it? God, which way do you want me to go? God, help me to increase my faith. God, help me to trust in you. God, help me to believe in you and not over my mind, not over my thoughts, not where my heart is feeling right now. Help me to be in sequence with the Holy Spirit. You know, so sometimes we can get so caught up with what we're going through and forget about all those other times that God done brought us out of things. All those other times that he saved us out of. And God had to remind me, like, you know, if you really gonna trust in me and you really gonna read my word and talk about my word, you got to believe every single thing that I placed in this word. So if I said that I'm going to do it, I'm going to get you out of it. That problem is big in front of you right now. That problem is hard that you're going through right now. That problem seems like, man, God, when are you going to come through? But he's going to come through. You know that the verse, you got to have a faith the size of a mustard seed and you can move mountains. Think of your problem as that mountain. Whatever mountain it is, it can be financial problem. It can be your child, your marriage, whatever that issue is, with faith, because the Bible talks about faith all the time. When you ain't got faith, you don't have nothing. So when you have that faith, you can move that mountain out of your way. I know God is going to come through for me. I know God is going to provide. I know God is going to do this very thing for me. So when you get into that mindset of, okay, God, I trust you because you did it before. I don't have room to doubt you. Then that's when your faith start building up. That's when your faith really start. You start seeing it manifest like, wow, God is doing this for me. It's just been God. So I want to go to one more scripture. I know my time goes so fast. The other scripture I wanted to go to is, I want to go to Philippians 4, 11 through 13. Let me read that real quick. So this is what it says. Philippians 4, verse 11 through 13. This is Paul speaking at this time. It says, not that I am speaking of being in need, for I have learned in whatever situation I am to be content. I know how to be brought low, and I know how to abound. In any and every circumstance, I have learned the secret of facing plenty and hunger, abundance, and need. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. What Paul is saying at this time is, you know, when he went through jail and he was going through all of these things, he experienced being hungry, he experienced being full, he experienced all type of things. But one thing that he mentions right here is, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Meaning that no matter what I face, when I have God inside of me, I can get through anything. The scripture, Bible also tells us that the Lord will never leave or forsake us. That is a promise. That is not just a statement. That is a promise. So God is not going to leave us and forsake us. He wants us to prosper. He wants us to believe in his word because he's going to do it. It's been so many times where I've been in these situations where I'm like, God, I don't know how this is about to go down. I don't know how you're about to do it, but I'm trusting you. And he do it. So that's why, when I had that moment, I had to step back like, China, God's going to do what he said he's going to do. And one more thing I wanted to say, I want to give some advice of the day. I know my time goes so fast, y'all. But the advice of the day I want to say is, no problem is greater than God. Stop worrying about today. We serve a God who is almighty and sovereign. The things we are stressing about today has already been worked out by God. But you have to trust. You have to trust him. So God bless you all. I will see you next Saturday. And you have a lovely weekend.